We've got a budget coming in just over 2 weeks' time, which is going to show New Zealanders the plan that we have to ensure we make up for the social and infrastructure deficits that we have been left. Now, Mr. Speaker, at the high level, the indicators of the New Zealand economy are strong, and that's good for New Zealand. There has been economic growth. But the problem is, who's shared in that? What share in prosperity have people got in the regions of New Zealand? What share in prosperity have low and middle income earners found over the last 9 years? And the problem for the previous national government is that while they made those indicators look good, they didn't pay the bills on the way. It's all very well to be able to claim a surplus if you haven't paid the bills for health, if you haven't paid the bills for education, if you haven't paid the bills for housing. What this government will do, Mr. Speaker, is that we will do the very thing New Zealanders want us to do. They want us to show responsibility in two ways. They want to show that we're responsible in our management of the finances of this country, and we will do that. But there's another kind of responsibility in government. A responsibility to future generations, to make sure that every New Zealand child gets the chance to grow up in a warm, dry home, that every New Zealand child gets the chance to enter into education and achieve their potential, that every single New Zealander knows that the health system will look after them when they get sick. Those basics on building blocks of our society have been run down, and this government is committed to turning them around. But, Mr. Speaker, over on Planet National, it's not good, because they're engaged in a very complicated game of Simon Says. Simon Says sits still in traffic in Auckland, because that's what's going to happen if the national government decides to repeal the regional fuel tax and leave the gap in the Auckland Transport Alignment Plan that had blown out to $9 billion under the previous national government. $9 billion. And there's no plan from the National Party to be able to say how they will get Auckland moving, how they will make sure the rail is there. No, there's not, Dr. Smith. The only thing was a gap, a giant $9 billion gap. And Simon Says, sit still. Simon Says also says, close your eyes. Simon Says, close your eyes.
Order,
because
order,
he...
order. That member's going to stop that now.
I didn't say which Simon, Mr. Speaker.
And I know which Simon the member is referring to.
Very wise man, Mr. Speaker. On the National Party side of the House there, Simon Bridges is saying, close your eyes. That's what Simon Bridges is saying. He's saying, close your eyes to the future of New Zealand as a sustainable economy. Because it's all very well to go along to your blue-green mates and say, we're going to reset the clock on the environment, and then there's no policy change. Simon Bridges says, close your eyes to climate change. Well, this side of the House says, no, we have to make sure that we do what is needed for future generations to prepare for a sustainable economy. Not just say it's going to happen, but have a just transition. And I feel sorry for Todd Muller, who's a good man, but he's the climate change spokesperson in a party that wants to close its eyes to climate change in the future. Mr. Speaker, on Planet National, the answer is, I don't know. I'm not sure what we're going to do. I don't have a plan for the future. On this side of the House, we have a plan for an economy that will be more productive, more sustainable and more inclusive. We started with a mini-budget before Christmas that actually is going to put money in the pockets of low- and middle-income families. When we have the budget in 2 weeks' time, we will rebuild the critical public services that New Zealanders need and deserve.